These home movies are great.
I've got all sorts of memories stored on my internal hard drive.
Ooh, ouch.
Hey, I never said you could feel that.
Nor this.
This show is over!
Wow! We're gonna meet Winston Churchill! He was one of Great Britain's most famous prime ministers. He rallied the British during World War II!
Yeah, looks like he rallied up some burgers and shakes while he is at it.
A return to civilization. I say, old chap, I could use a spot of tea.
Hey, you start talking British on me, Larry, so help me, I'll clobber you.
Guys, something weird is going on here.
Kid, traveling through history is always weird. Weird food, weird accents, stupid languages.
It's true. Something is definitely off. I can't put my finger on it.
Extra! Extra! Read all about it! Germans march on Poland!
Oh my gosh! Everyone's naked!
We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills, and above all, we shall fight without clothes on.
Yes, well, yeah.
Robert!
Yes, well said.
Robert!
Yes, well said indeed.
Well done. Well done.
Interesting speech, Mr. Churchill, sir.
Thank you, lad. There's a war on. Got to inspire the people, you know.
Yeah, that's, great. I can see how that would be, how you might be, where the heck are your pants?
My boy, we are engaged in a battle for freedom. Freedom to vote, freedom to think, and freedom to wear whatever we want, even if it's nothing at all.
Now that's just plain wrong.
And historically, it's way off.
Oh, but it's jolly fun. So liberating. Oh, you ought to try it. You've got nothing to lose but your underwear. Oh, that's a good one. What? Lose your underwear?
No, maybe he's onto something. I'm already naked.
Delightful, isn't it?
As a matter of fact, it is!
And it's even better at 100 kilometers per hour.
Yippee!
What the heck are you doing, Larry?
Shedding the clothes I never had!
I'm king of the world!
Your sense of decency!
Hello! Last one in the English Channel, the rotten egg!
A 300-pound man skinny dipping with the robot. That is just not right.
I gotta wash my eyes.
Oh, join us, lads.
Cannonball!
The water is perfect.
We didn't bring our swimsuits.
That's the point. After skinny dipping, nothing is more exhilarating than reviewing your troops. No trousers, no shirts, no socks. I'm building a lean, mean fighting machine.
Oh! Oh! Blimey! Oh!
Ah. Barefoot against the Germans? That ain't gonna work.
It's glorious. It's frivolous.
It's World War II, Larry. We gotta make sure the British beat the Germans.
It's the mission, Larry, remember?
Mission? Now that I've realized I'm naked, the mission seems a million miles away.
Do me a favor and quit telling me you're naked. Right? It freaks me out.
There's hope yet. The British still have an air force!
Hey, man, these guys are freezing.
Oh, nonsense, boy. That's merely the feeling of invigoration that comes with casting off one's garments.
As well as one's inhibitions.
This is nuts! You guys are miserable, right?
No.
It's all right.
Well, I quite like it.
Yeah, quite like it, I guess.
Even the Royal Navy?
In the buff.
Me change.
Oh, me blooming library card.
Sir, they've got nowhere to put their stuff. These guys need pockets.
Oh, poppycock. You lads want pockets?
No.
Hey, we got company.
Oh, my gosh. It's FDR and Stalin. Thank goodness. These guys will straighten Churchill out. You gotta help us. Churchill's naked.
He's got the whole British Army going nudie.
Going nudie, huh?
Looks like fun.
Oh, I'm game.
Me too also.
No, no, no!
Well, who's hungry? Naked barbecue, anyone? Naked barbecue!
Oh, boy!
That's game!
Oh, Stalin, you stinker!
You know I hate to admit it, but you cooked a mean burger there, Winston.
Okay, everyone, home movie time!
Oh, I hope it's a talkie!
Indeed, and you'll be pleased to know my latest directorial outing is happily sans Todd Russell.
Huh?
It's just me and my new naked chum, Winston.
Oh, bravo. Oh, good show, old boy.
There we are, riding motorcycles.
Hello. Yeah, yeah.
Reviewing troops.
Jolly good.
And cooking burgers.
Well done, Lawrence. Only one question. Who's the fellow with the gigantic butt?
Why, Winston, that's you.
What? That's me? That's what I look like naked.
Well, the camera does add 15 pounds.
It's horrible. It's indecent. Put something on, gentlemen. You look positively obscene.
You did it, Larry! You saved the mission!
Oh, I didn't want to save the mission. Naked is beautiful!
I think if we learned anything today, it's that naked is not beautiful.
You got that right. From now on, Larry, you're wearing pants.
I will not! Don't touch me!
Put them on! Put them on!
Tuskegee, Alabama, circa 1915. Woodrow Wilson is president, the Model T Ford is in full production, and it's the dawn of a new century.
Yeah, super. So, who are we looking for again?
George Washington Carver.
Right, yeah, the guy who chopped down the cherry tree.
No, you're thinking of George Washington, America's first president. This George was the scientist who came up with more than 100 uses for the peanut.
Sounds like a smart guy. But I bet he can't outsmart my new Laser Pro 950. Ho, ho, hey, ha-ha!
Would you please stop waving that gun around?
Oh, it's more than just a gun, Lair. It's night vision goggles, a shoe bumper, toothpick dispenser. Oops.
I'm thrilled.
Not as thrilled as these people, apparently.
Oh, it was delicious.
Hiya, folks. Happy Peanut Day to you. Those little goobers are a miracle. They've given us everything from shoes to shakes to shaving cream that leaves your face feeling not only smooth, but, peanutty. That Carver guy is a genius.
That's strange. Seems like Carver's doing exactly what he was supposed to be doing.
Indeed. Where's the glitch?
Beats me. But these shakes sure hit the spot. Free peanuts! Get your free peanuts! Peanuts here, right here!
You're just giving them away?
That's right.
Skull and crossbones? That's a strange marking for a peanut.
Who cares? I'm nuts for these nuts!
You are nuts! Or should I say fools? For playing right into my hands. Y'all just love George Washington Carver. You just love his 100 uses for the peanut. I'll show you 100 uses for the peanut. 100 evil uses!
Holy moly! George Washington Carver's autograph! Now my life's complete!
Well, anything for a true fan of the peanut.
Excuse me, sir, Officer Buck Tud Russell, Time Squad. We're investigating alleged reports of historical inaccuracies, deviations, and, wrongnesses.
Well, if you're investigating peanuts, you've come to the right place. From Sioux City to Okefenokee, folks are finding out the peanut's good for just about everything. Floor wax, invisible ink, bubble bath, kitty litter, bug spray, massage oil, decongestant, fertilizer, shave cream.
Wow. That's amazing!
The sky's the limit with a peanut in it. Later today, I'm unveiling my latest, greatest use for peanuts ever.
Ooh, I'm all a tingle.
Hey, boss, we handed out all the peanuts like you said.
Perfect. My entire life I've waited for this moment when I could take revenge upon my brother George. Mom always did like him best. But I... Todd Washington Carver was the true genius.
Hey, boss, can we take these off now? This getup's too tight.
Oh, no, leave them on.
But it's too hot.
Yeah, and I can't see. These eye holes are off center.
Listen, I want you looking like peanuts. It's a matter of thematic continuity. Now for the final phase.
And in appreciation, the citizens of Tuskegee would like to give this great American the key to our humble city.
Wow! The whole town turned out for this.
Maybe this mission was a false alarm.
Oh, yeah. Things seem hunky-dory to me. Let's head back.
What's that?
Why, it's a peanut-shaped blimp.
Greetings, citizens of Tuskegee. I've come to join your little party.
Why, it's my little brother, Todd Washington Carver. What an unexpected surprise.
That's right, George. I've come to celebrate Peanut Day with you.
But I thought you hated a peanut.
I do, and so will everyone else when they see my 100 ways the peanut stinks, like evil use number 52, peanut pellets.
Ow! These peanuts hurt!
Hurt like the dickens!
Evil use number 78, smelly peanut gas.
We've got to do something.
All right. It is time for the Laser Pro 950 to blow that blimp out of the sky. Corkscrew? What the?
This peanut gas is burning my eyes.
I hate peanuts.
Nail file, magnifying glass. Come on, where's that dang anti-battery? What the? Grappling hook?
And now for evil use number 81. Possibly the most evil of all uses. A little treat for all of you who ate those free peanuts.
Turn the townspeople into zombies!
Must attack Mayor!
Must destroy George Washington Carver!
I devoted my life to peanuts, and now the little goobers are causing havoc!
We're trapped!
We're doomed!
Maybe not! Peanuts created these zombies. I bet they can stop them.
Nah, I'm done with peanuts.
Wait, what was your latest use for the peanut? The one you were going to unveil today?
Oh, just peanut glue. But it's useless now that everyone hates peanuts.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Time Squad, reach for the sky!
Get him, you fools!
Whiff!
I can't see him. Ooh. Get off of me!
I can't.
Get your hand on
him. Off of me, you... You'll never take me alive, copper!
Sounds good to me. Oh, crud! Smoke screen!
Now's my chance!
Your peanut glue stopped the zombies.
Hey, maybe peanuts ain't so bad after all.
No, sir, Mr. Carver.
Now, come on, let's go. The laser, it worked. What did you do?
I think I pressed this button here.
That's the self-destruct button.
Oh, drag.
Good work, officer.
Book 'em, boys.
What happened?
Hey, this sticky peanut stuff is tasty.
Ooh, I bet this would be great on bread with jelly.
Fantastic. Why did I think of that?